I think this is the most important hour I have ever been a part of in broadcast. I've done this for 45 years. This is the most important person and hour you can spend.
Especially when you're interviewing somebody you don't really know that well. You don't ask a question without knowing how your guest is going to answer the question. Every time you break that rule, bad things can happen. Don Lemon over at CNN learned that the hard way last night.
Don Lemon decides you belt out the so-called Black National Anthem. And actually, it's not that bad. Watch this.
Lift every voice and sing. Till earth and heaven ring, ring with the harmony of liberty.
So the TV thing's not working out for him. Let's be honest, he's on the morning show. That's the last step. But he does have a future. Weddings, bar mitzvahs, bachelorette parties. Like, you might want to hire that guy. We'll see what happens, and we'll keep you posted.
Protection for gangs crossing nations, causing grief in human relations. It's a turf war on a global scale. I'd rather hear both sides of the tale. See, it's not about races, just places, faces. Where your blood comes from is where your space is. I've seen the bright get duller. I'm not gonna spend my life being a color.
Do you agree with me?
Have you thought about New Year's resolutions?
I have.
You're kind of an anti-resolution guy.
I don't really do it. I always live my life to the very fullest. And
yes,
I,
you do.
The thing is, I need a little bit more balance in work life. We should not sanitize that word by saying, this person called such and such the N-word. No, that person didn't call that person the N-word. That person called Sonny, I know you're going to get upset, that person called you or that person a nigger. They didn't say the N-word.
I can't believe,
as journalists,
we are conveyors. You're going to use that word just
of course, because
words
we're
matter,
using
and
it.
And you should know that.
And I would challenge any of your listeners and yourself to find any instance of it being the other way around.
Thank you, Mr. Bevan. You don't have to call people names in order to discriminate against somebody who can be equally as harmful. I appreciate your time on my show. Thank you so much for joining me.
I'm a bad person to date. I'm not selfish. I'll give you my laugh, but I'm very self-centered. Yeah. I'm not going to be as self-centered.
You're going to be less self-centered.
If reparations need to be paid, we need to go right back to the beginning of that supply chain and say, who was rounding up their own people and having them handcuffing pages? Absolutely, that's where they should start. And maybe, I don't know, the descendants of those families where they died at in the high seas trying to stop the slavery, that those families should receive something too, I think, at the same time.
Maybe Lemon ended the interview and didn't argue because of his new boss, Chris Licht. Licht shaking up CNN, including sending Lemon to the morning show. That's not okay with people who love cable news where nobody questions their prized but relatively fragile positions, from Keith Oberman. Chris Licht, who when we worked together at MSNBC, I believe used to eat paste, has now surrounded Don Lemon with an ex-Daily Caller journalist and somebody who last month demanded an apology from Biden to Republicans. The CNN bleep storm, according to Mr. Oberman, is here. I'm old enough to remember when having people of opposing and differing views was a good thing. It wasn't a bleep storm.
talking about religion here and the interpretation of the Bible. This is something that reminded me of something that I saw on television years ago. It's from a television show called West Wing. Take a look.
I don't say homosexuality is an abomination, Mr. President. The Bible does.
Yes, it does. Leviticus
18:22.
Chapter and verse.
Frankly, what you're asking me to do is make commentary on a television program. I'm talking about
real life. But it's about actual real-life Bible verses. There are real-life Bible verses.
I'm running for governor.
I understand that. But Mr. Bevin, will you answer my question? Those are real-life Bible verses that he's referring to.
If you would stop talking about
that. Well, I will stop talking, but anyway. Those are real-life Bible verses that he's referring to.
You're showing an amazing
I'm not showing it. I'm asking you.
You're selectively choosing.
No, but that's what she's doing. That is a criticism of her.
Let me tell you.
That is not the criticism of me. Hang on. Will you let me finish? Will you let me finish, and then I'll answer, and then you can answer the question. What she has done is interpreted certain...
I'm a little bit upset here.
I'm not upset. I'm just trying to get you to answer the question. You're the one who is not answering the question. What she has done... has picked the Bible verses.
John, I appreciate your now theological expertise, and I appreciate you sharing that with your audience, but the bottom line is this.
A couple things. I don't know everybody else's salary, so I can't say that it's a, you know, and it's a boys' club. I just got there.
You don't think it's a boys' club, as
I don't think it's
You're having lunch with Zucker. I'm guessing she's not.
Well, I don't know who's... I mean, I actually called him up and said, would you like to have lunch? I mean, she can do the same thing.
And he said, I just got here. Well, she's only been there 15 years. Time moves quickly when you work in a cable patriarchy. Once you get past Mr. Lamont's line, we did notice something else. He was mansplaining, if you can imagine. Like, sitting knees open on the subway, lecturing Brooke Baldwin on how to get invited to the bro lunch with Jeff Zucker.
But it had to do with white power.
What is happening?
I don't know what's happening. But we'll leave that alone because...
Breaking news here at noon, Tucker Carlson is out at Fox News Channel, effective immediately. In a statement, Fox News Media said it was mutually parting ways with its top-rated primetime host.
Now, we know that Don Lemon might have striked you as the poster child for toxic masculinity, but that's exactly what that was, casual sexism. He didn't even realize it. Don Lemon needs to check himself and his male privilege. Stop the mansplaining.
Someone did something a little weird to me when I was down there.
I don't want to know.
I thought I told you to turn that thing off! It is too late and it's too loud!
But Dad, this is the best part.
You are wasting your time with this garbage. Now go to bed!
Warfare between good and evil.
Take care, fisherman in a box.
Yeah.